much for joining us today. Your curiosity is wonderful. And just like all of you, it was my own curiosity about nature that led me to working right here at SeaWorld. We receive so many questions about killer whales each and every day from kids and grown-ups of all ages. So we gathered all those questions right here in the Killer Whales Up Close book to share with you today. And we connected the book so that you'll be able to see everything up on our big screens. Now, if you're ready to get started, it's my privilege to introduce you to Summer.
Hello, Jenna, thank you. Welcome to Champions Stadium. Are you guys ready to meet some of our amazing killer whales? Yeah. All right, well, I'm honored to share some of these amazing animals with you. Coming up first, he is 13 years old. He is known to be one of our most goofy whales. He seems to enjoy any and all attention he can get from his trainers. He loves relationship building and play sessions. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the one and only Ikaika!
We have a unique opportunity to conduct research about killer whales. asking important questions that can only be answered in a setting like this. So much of what we learn here is being used to help killer whales in the wild. Of course, there are other questions that can only be explored by studying whales in the ocean. By exploring questions both at SeaWorld and in the wild, our combined research gives all of us a better understanding of killer whales and the places they live.
And that's what I call working together. Research flowing in both directions, from our part to the wild and back again. That way, everyone benefits. All right, time for another question, and perfect. This individual wonders why whales jump. Well, I just happened to that emoji. Look. You know, killer whales communicate in a lot of different ways. Sometimes they vocalize, and sometimes they use their bodies.
As a calf grows and gains some independence, it is looked after by other whales in the pod too. They help the mother protect the calf, teach it survival skills, and show the calf how to romp and play. Killer whales live in family-like groups known as pods. Like human families, their pods can range in size from just a handful of whales up to a few dozen.
Questions. But believe it or not, we get them here every day.
We sure do. The killer whales communicate using all sorts of sounds.
Sometimes they blow bubbles or bump into each other, or even scratch each other with their teeth, causing something called rake marks. And those are the multi-line marks that you might see on the skin of killer whales and dolphins. And it's just one of the ways that they display dominance over each other during social interaction, both in the wild and here at SeaWorld. So we've just heard how killer whales communicate with each other, but do you know how we communicate with them? We use signals. And here at SeaWorld, we really do communicate with our whales. And we want future generations to be able to do the same.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are to my favorite part of the show. Today we have two very special volunteers who are going to get the opportunity to interact with Ikaika and Corky through those hand signals that we talked about earlier. So once again, ladies and gentlemen, looks like she's gonna get a nice big killer whale wave hello. And it looks like Kavya is also gonna tell Corky hello. Kristi is going to be sensations on their tongue. So this is one of the many ways that we can reinforce them. It's something that they behaviorally seem to enjoy.
They ate it.
All right, you two, to commemorate your experience here at Shamu Stadium, we'd like to offer the two of you a whale tail necklace. Once again, Valerie and Kavya.
No. Who takes care of you, Shamu? It's another great question, and I love that question. It lets us show you how much we really care about these extraordinary animals. So, Summer, is everyone ready?
We sure are. The training you're about to see is actually how we take care of our animals. There's a variety of different husbandry behaviors that we have trained so we can maintain the best health care possible. So when the whales learn to roll over and offer their tail fins, like Ikaika is doing right here close in front of us, one of our veterinarians can come in to draw blood and check their health. Now, this is just one of the many behaviors that we do here. We can get culture samples as they exhale from their blowhole. We do body exams daily, urine samples. But another type of husbandry behavior that is very important is a slide-out behavior like Corky, who is sitting on stage, and I kind of want to exhibit it right here up close. Now, this is a great photo opportunity for all of you, but it's important that we track their weight to make sure that they're staying healthy and that the calves are growing properly. Now, the high-energy behaviors like backflips and breaches are behaviors that some of us do here at SeaWorld and out in the wild. So if you want to focus your attention, we can have Corky over here to our left. She's going to do a small jump in the corner of the pool. And then I'd like all of you to focus your attention to the center of the pool. All right, looks like she's going to the center. Great behavior. Now these are the types of behaviors that help ensure that the killer whales get the proper exercise they need each and every day.
And I know that our guests also always wonder, well, how much does a killer whale need to eat every day to stay healthy?
Well, just like us, each killer whale has different dietary needs. Amaya, who is 17 months old, she eats 33 pounds of fish, whereas her father, who is our largest whale, just under 10,000 pounds, he eats up to 180 pounds of fish every day. It's important to note, regardless of what the whales do, they receive all of their food every day.
Because we've been able to determine how much killer whales eat throughout different stages of their life, researchers in the field are able to determine if ocean habitats are healthy enough for wild populations of killer whales to thrive. And that type of information is invaluable.
You know, food, exercise, and physical from our veterinarians aren't all our killer whales need. Each whale's well-being is so important to us, we want to make sure their minds are stimulated and challenged too. We need the kind of mental enrichment and stimulation that comes from learning, interaction, and play. Now, if you focus your attention on the screen, you're going to notice some kelp that they're playing and interacting with, even some sugarless jello that is sucked into the inside of the glass, and even a submerged toy, we call those environmental enrichment devices, that they're playing, interacting with, and this is something that we've created for them. Now, each and every whale has a different personality, like we talked about earlier in the show, and each and every trainer has a different relationship with that whale. So what's fun and unique about these play sessions is that each trainer can decide what they think their animal behaviorally seems to enjoy and what their connection and relationship is. So if you want to focus your attention over here to our left, Amber is just doing a little water pour with Ikaika. Now, Amber is relatively new on Ikaika, and this is something that he has shown us that he seems to enjoy. So this is just hanging out with him and also doing something that he finds fun. Whereas on our right, we see Kristi, and she's having some fun. Yes, get to throw some ice cubes to Corky. Now, Corky loves ice cubes, like we talked about earlier, but also because she is our oldest whale, we call her the trainer's trainer. She's the one that trains the newer trainers. So she definitely finds children interacting and playing with her fun and stimulating. And again, it's just knowing that animal. But with all the games and toys we provide, the best enrichment still seems to be the social interaction with the other whales and our team of experienced trainers.
Okay, now here's a question for all you kids out there, because I know you want to know, who would win if a killer whale squared off with a great white shark? So, let's take a poll. Raise your hands out there if you think that the great white shark would win. Okay, I see a couple hands. Now raise your hands if you think the killer whales would win. Yeah, that's right, the killer whales. You see, a great white shark hunts alone, but a killer whale hunts with a whole pod. So it's not even a competition. And you know, killer whales have even been known to hunt blue whales. You guys know how big a blue whale is? At over 80 feet, it's the largest animal ever to have existed on our planet. But killer whales can hunt these huge animals because they coordinate, they collaborate, and they cooperate. Yeah, they work together as a group to overcome challenges much bigger than themselves. And you know, I think that we could learn a lot from killer whales on how to overcome challenges that, say, our ocean faces. Maybe if we work together, we could change the fate of the ocean. And who knows, maybe even one day, the world. All right, more questions. And here's some of those really common ones that always come in. So here we go, first question. Why do some dorsal fins curve? That's a great question. You see, dorsal fins lack any sort of skeletal support, such as bones or cartilage, to support their entire height and weight. They're completely made up of something called connective tissue. So if an animal spends more time at the surface, over time, the tissue inside that fin might weaken and the fin could bend. Now, occasionally we see these curved dorsal fins, like you see here in the photos out in the wild and here at SeaWorld. Okay, next question. Ooh, how fast can they swim? Well, depending on their size and weight, killer whales can reach speeds of almost 30 miles an hour. Let's check it out. If all of the whales splashed at once, could they get the whole audience wet? Maybe not the whole audience.
Thank you.
station. So never stop wondering about that natural world around you. And be sure to visit SeaWorldSanDiego.com for your free download of our killer whales at Close Up and share it.